Hi guys, how are you? I hope all you are doing good. Welcome to the Edu Everybody. Let's experience the education. So in this video, we will go through the visibility, text decoration and float. This is the CSS property. Let's learn about the visibility. So let's learn about the visibility. So let's open our VS Code. So we have made this in the last video. So assume that I'm going to make two more div here. So first I'm making the p1, and here I'm writing the p1 tag as first block. Then I'm copying the same thing and I'm pasting here, but id could not be same, so here I'm giving the p2. Let's see the output here. So here I'm giving some style to p1 and p2. The border is 1 pixel solid red. Then we have a border radius. Now let's give some padding here. Padding is 10 pixel. Let's give some margin at 10 pixel. So this is done. Okay, if we open our live server, so let's click on this. So it has been open. As you can see, both have been open. Okay, now what here I need to do here, so I am writing here visibility as visible. So this is a default value, so there will be no change on the output side, as you can see. But here if I give the hidden, now as you can see the block has been hidden, but space is still remain. If you open the developer tool, then as you can see here and you can move this one to here. So this is our p1. So you can make use of developer tool. You can click here, and when you move your pointer to at any element, it will be highlighted. So as you can see, I have make the p1 as hidden, but the space is still remain. As you can see, the space is still remain. You cannot use this one space. So this is the difference between the visibility and the hidden. Hidden makes your block as hidden, but it does not free up the space. The space cannot be used by another element, because element is still in a DOM. As you can see, the element is still in a DOM. It has not been gone somewhere. It is still there. That's why the space is not free, but the element has been hidden. I hope that is clear. Now the second thing we will learn about that text decoration. So for that I will use the live preview. So here I have made my h1. I have made the author name class. ये हमारा है ये by Abhishek Jaiswal. Okay, हम लोग यहाँ पे क्या दे सकते हैं? टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन लाइन दे सकते हैं, टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन कलर दे सकते हैं, टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन स्टाइल कर सकते हैं. पहले टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन लाइन का पढ़ लेते हैं. टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन लाइन का मतलब क्या है कि हम लोग टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन लाइन का क्या मतलब है कि हम लोग ओवरलाइन, अंडरलाइन एंड लाइन थ्रू, ये तीन चीजें हम लोग यूज कर सकते हैं. ओवरलाइन अगर हम करेंगे तो एज यू कैन सी द लाइन हैज बीन कम ओवर द कंटेंट. अगर मैं इसको रिमूव करके मैं अगर दूसरा यूज करूँ अंडरलाइन, तो ये अंडरलाइन में आ जाएगा. मैं इसकी जगह अगर लाइन थ्रू यूज करता हूँ तो वो कट कर देगा इसको. ओके, क्रॉस कर देगा. और आप चाहते हो कि इसका कलर बदल दिया जाए, मतलब हम कलर ब्लू नहीं चाहते. अभी ये क्या कर रहा है, ये कलर को भी वही कलर एक्वायर कर रहा है जो टेक्स्ट का कलर है, तो वो उसकी डिफॉल्ट वैल्यू है. अगर कल टेक्स्ट वाइट है तो ये लाइन भी वाइट हो जाएगी, बट हम चाहते हैं कि ये रेड हो जाए. हम चाहते हैं कि लाइन थ्रू एंड टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन लाइन. सो हेयर आई नीड टू राइट हेयर टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन, बिकॉज टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन होल्ड ऑल थ्री property, but text decoration line only holds the type of line which you want, only hold that which line you want. So it has been red. But you want, I do not want the straight one. I want the dotted one. I want something else. So for that you can use here text decoration style, this one. Okay, you can write here separately. Okay, otherwise you can use a shorthand. Shorthand tells you a text decoration line, then text decoration color, then text decoration style. So you can write here dotted, dashed, double, and I think one more is there, that is wavy. As you can see, this is in wavy color. If I, maybe it is visible to you, I hope this is visible. If I write here dotted, dashed, dotted, if I write here double, so the line has been doubled. If I will show you here, as you can see, the line has been doubled here. I hope you are clear with this one as well. Now the third one we will learn about the float. So float moves your content left and right. So here I have already used the float value. So this is our h1. So if I can text decoration under red. Okay, so right now we have moved the content in the right, that's why bi-fcsval is in the right side. If I comment it, so it is in the mid. If I move it to the left, then I need to write here left, so it is in the left. So you can apply the float on this element bi-fcsval, and this is the h1. I have given the name, I have given the class name, class author, author name class. This is the class name of the h1 tag, that's why I am giving the style to that particular element. With the help of float you can move it to left and right. And maybe sometimes it happens that when you give the float to any element, then it will go to out of the div tag or out of the parent tag. So what you can do, you can give the overflow as auto. सो वॉट इट मीन्स कि जब आप फ्लोट को इधर उधर देते हो तो फ्लोट क्या करता है, कंटेंट को बाहर भी कर सकता है, ओवरफ्लो कर सकता है. तो आप उसके पेरेंट एलिमेंट को ओवरफ्लो दे दो, तो आप ओवरफ्लो दे दोगे तो ये ना इंटेलिजेंट बन जाएगा कि ये जान जाएगा कि ये कंटेंट मेरे से बाहर जा रहा है, तो वो उसको अंदर कर लेगा. तो ओवरफ्लो की दिक्कत नहीं आएगी. आई होप दैट इज क्लियर गाइज. सो आई विल मीट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो विद द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. टिल देन बाय बाय, टेक केयर एंड प्लीज लाइक सब्सक्राइब एंड कमेंट इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल.